for the City of Hayes Commission meeting for Thursday, May 11th. First item on the agenda would be approval of the April 27th. Any changes? Okay, stand as written. Next item on the agenda would be citizen comments.
That'd be me.
Welcome.
Hi, I'm Mary Karst. I'm co-president of the Wild West Festival Committee. And on behalf of the committee, we understand that now we'll be submitting our funding request each year directly to the city manager's office, which we have done. But we wanted to take this time to extend a special thank you to the entire city commission for all the support they've given us over the years. I mean, this is our 23rd year, and we couldn't do it without the support of the entire community and the city commission. And we hope that that support continues into the future, of course. And we also wanted to extend a special invitation to the city commission and the city managers and so forth. This year we are teaming up with the Hayes Convention and Visitors Bureau to make our parade a sesquicentennial parade. So we're calling it 150 years out west. And we would love it if the city commissioners and the city manager's office would be part of that parade and represent the city either walking or riding in a car or something like that. So consider this your personal invitation to be part of the parade, and a special thank you from the committee for all that you've done.
Thank you for all your work.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it.
Mary,
thank you.
Only thing I'd like to say is, because you're submitting directly, you're not bringing a presentation here. Anytime the Wild West Fest would like to come and visit with us and tell us what's going on, I think I speak for us all. We love hearing what's going on, so don't ever hesitate to come.
Well, I appreciate that, but we also understand that you have time constraints that you're trying to stick with, and everybody's got busy lives, so we just wanted to take a few minutes to say thank you.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We do appreciate it, and I appreciate the volunteers for your group. I don't think there's been very many years since I've lived in Hayes that I've missed Wild West Fest, and it's I truly enjoy it. A few years ago, I think I told somebody this today, when Loverboy was there, I told my wife, oh, it's going to be awesome, and well, I thought it was awesome, but she didn't care for it so much. But anyway, I love the Wild West Fest, and my kids love going out there, and I look forward to it this year. So,
thank you. The committee works really hard to make it happen.
They do.
Thank you guys
thank
for
you. Thank you.
For Hayes.
Thank you.
You bet. Anyone else?
Yeah. You don't have to sit through it.
We're all dressed up.
They were great.
Thank you guys.
Thanks
very
all
much.
For coming.
Thank you. I'd just like to add to it, you're all welcome to come down and help us set up.
No. Tear down. That's more fun.
All right. Sean, thank you.
I'll see what I can do.
Be there on the 5th.
Thank you, guys. All right. Next item on the agenda would be employee promotions and new hires.
Good evening, commissioners. Jeff Crispin, interim director of Water Resources. So I'm kind of excited I get to kick this one off tonight. And Tobin Miller, he's been with the city for 15 years. Some of you may have met Tobin before. He started with the city back in June 2002. He was our interim maintenance foreman for probably the past 11 months. Took over for a retired maintenance foreman that had been with the city for quite a few years. The buzzword in the industry right now is infrastructure. And I think we've all heard that, and that's pretty important. Started with maintenance and doing water line repairs, maintenance of our streets. Back when he started with us, and he went over to solid waste for a little bit, came back, and he's learned from that previous manager a lot of things. And one thing I can count on in my new role and my previous role as assistant director is asking him questions about water lines and where things are. He knows a lot, and I'm confident that we're in good hands with this guy right here. So I'm pretty proud of him. But this is Tobin.
Welcome, Tobin.
Very good.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you for your service. Appreciate it very much.
Good evening, commissioners. Jeff Boyle, director of parks. This is Matt Winholtz. Matt Winholtz has been with the city for about 7.5 months now. Matt was recently promoted to a maintenance 2 worker. Matt previously worked for Ellis County for 2 years and the city of Ellis for 16 years. So we are very fortunate to have Matt working for the Parks Department. He's very capable, has lots of knowledge, skills, and abilities. So we're very, very happy to have Matt on board.
Very good. Welcome, Matt, and congratulations.
The
evening. Carolyn McCollum Scantlin, Director of the Communications Center. I'm here with our very newest city employee, as far as I know. This is Andrew Shealy. He started with us on Monday, May the 8th. He was raised in Concordia. He came to Hayes, go to Fort Hayes. He's married, and he's coming to us from Walmart, and we're delighted to have him. I think he's going to be an excellent asset to our department.
Awesome. Very good. Well, welcome, welcome. Welcome.
Thank you.
And Mayor, Commissioners, this is a kind of a new segment that we're adding to the commission meetings, something that one of the commissioners or maybe several commissioners requested that we do on a more periodic basis. So every month when we have new hires or promotions, we'll be bringing those to the commission just to introduce them and kind of get their face in front of the commission. So.
I appreciate that. I really enjoy, you know, we see a lot of you guys, but sometimes it's put a name with the face is really nice to see you guys. And, you know, I welcome it anytime. So thank you guys for all coming tonight, too.
I too, Jacob. I really appreciate it. I appreciate being able to see the faces of the people that we've talked, but be able to thank you for your service. And it is sincere and it's appreciated. So thank you for taking the time to come.
Okay, next item on the agenda would be the consent agenda. The first item on the consent agenda would be some appointments for approval tonight. Dustin Shafley to the Hayes Area Planning Commission, Jim Schreiber for the Hayes Beautification Committee, Marjorie Hammerschmidt, Hayes Housing Authority Board, Albert Klaus, Hayes Public Library Board, Mary Tepfer. And then if you'll look, I have some recommendations. I'm not going to read through all those tonight. So, for approval.
Move to approve the consent agenda as presented.
I'll second that.
Motion by Commissioner Swaller, second by Commissioner Jacobs. Any comments?
It's a privileged motion.
No. Oh, okay. I will say I appreciate all the people stepping up and willing to serve our community. So,
good job.
Okay, motion say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Passes 4-0. Okay, unfinished business, no. Next item on the agenda, building abatement, 3310 Vine Street.
Good evening, Jesse Rohr, Planning Inspection Enforcement Superintendent. Tonight, for this item, staff is requesting approval of a resolution allowing the structural damage at 3310 Vine, Suite 30, to be repaired per adopted ordinance. Most of you are probably familiar with how the site looks. It still looks that way pretty much today. This is a picture of the damaged structure covered up temporarily with wood sheathing. Several attempts have been made by staff to have the issue corrected, which resulted in lots of promises, but no action. In short, the property was damaged. The property owner was notified with no results. And now we're moving forward to get the damage corrected. The new door is actually on hand with a local contractor and has been for several months. Staff has been in contact with the contractor, and if you do choose to pass and approve the resolution tonight, we will be working with that contractor to get the repairs made. For this item, the City Commission has the following options. You can either approve the resolution as submitted, or you could not approve the resolution and provide staff with other direction. Staff would recommend approving the resolution allowing the structure at 3310 Vine, the structural damage to the door, to be repaired and brought up to code compliance. With that, I would take any questions you might have.
Jesse, I have a question real quick. This started back in November or September?
Last fall, October, September, late September maybe, right.
The letters you sent. So what, how do you, I don't want to ask this, when we start something like this, I mean, okay, we waited almost 2 years to get this done. I mean, what triggers us to say, okay, enough is enough? It's just complaint from the community?
This was actually a complaint. Okay. It was a complaint basis. Even before we started the official process, we were in contact with the property owner for quite a while. Again, it was, I'll get it fixed. I've got an insurance claim.
Right.
I've contacted a contractor. We've got the door on site. We confirmed all that, so we thought things were moving along and progressing. But when it came time to actually make the corrections, take care of the damage, things kind of fell apart. The property's for sale. There's other issues with the property, kind of led and kind of drug it out, and finally decided it was time to step in and move forward with it.
Mr. Chairman, I move we approve Resolution 2017-006 to abate the structure issue located at the property at 3310 Vine Street, Suite 30, and of 10 days after approval.
Second.
Okay, motion by Commissioner Swaller, second by Commissioner Jones. Any comments?
I just have one question. How does the city get reimbursed for
taxes?
After the corrections are done, we actually send an invoice. We give them the opportunity to pay. If they don't pay, then it's filed with the county assessor's office and placed as lien on the property.
So it's the equivalent of a tax that the county puts on there, and then when they eventually collect the tax, then we get paid. And if it gets sold for taxes, it gets sold for this too. But that's not going to happen on this one. So.
That's what I thought.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
That's a
good point.
You're welcome.
All in favor of the motion, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye. Aye. Mr. Forlum.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesse. Hey, Jesse, real quick, can I just add on to that a little bit? I've noticed, just around town, we have some other buildings that are, I actually think, are in worse shape, possibly. I mean, what, how do we, I mean, I know this is right on Vine, it's a very popular place, but there's places downtown that have been like that since I've lived in Hayes.
Yeah, you know, like I said, this one was addressed on a complaint.
Okay.
If you know specific properties, we can address them. We can start processes on any of the buildings that meet criteria, fall under the criteria of the property maintenance code, whether it's a similar issue or worse. We've got steps in place that we can take to take action if necessary. So. If you or if you hear from citizens of issues, different buildings, let us know, and we'll take action. So
I don't want to be out there searching. I mean, I think that'd be something that wouldn't be worthwhile, but there's some places that are pretty big eyesore, a few places. So
right. We actually have a couple of those we're working on right now. I think they'll get resolved before coming here, but you know, there's a couple others.
Okay. I was just curious. I need to
in the works,
so. Review that before I would do anything. So.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Jesse. Appreciate
Thanks,
it.
Jesse.
I wondered why you kept driving by my house.
Well, I was hoping you'd notice. But anyway, next item on the agenda would be the Service Division Dump Truck Award of Bid.
Good evening, Commissioners. I'm John Brown. I'm the Assistant Director of Public Works. The 2017 budget included funds to purchase a new dump truck for Service Division. City staff solicited bids for a single-axle, 5-cubic-yard dump truck, complete with snow plow and sand salt spreader. As I attempted to explain at last week's work session, the new dump truck will replace 837, which is shown here, which is used by Service Division as one of six trucks used for snow and ice removal and general construction maintenance operations throughout the year. This truck, 837, would then replace 839, which is solely used by Water Resources Maintenance for waterline breaks. This truck is worn out and needs to be sold at auction, along with an old plow and spreader that only fit that truck. Four bids were opened on March 28th, 2017. The low bid, which includes the truck, the dump bed, plow, and spreader, is from Summit Truck Group of Salina at a price of $139,151. The fleet replacement schedule in the 2017 budget included $163,000 for the replacement of the existing dump truck. The low bid of $139,151 is below the budgeted amount. The funding would come out of the new equipment reserve fund. City Commission has the option of accepting the bid from Summit Truck Group, directing staff to another option, or rejecting all the bids. Staff recommends that the City Commission award the low bid to Summit Truck Group of Salina in the amount of $139,151. So the action requested is posted for your pleasure.
Mr. Chairman, can we see the bids again? Can we see the bids again?
See the bids again, please?
Yes.
Thank you.
John, can I assume when I see these four bids that these were all the bids received?
That was all the bids that were received. We advertised in the paper. We put it on the website. We sent the request for bids out to all local vendors, and these are the bids we received back.
Mr. Chairman, I move we award the bid of the purchase of the new International 7400 truck and Henderson bed, Monroe 11-foot snowplow, and Henderson 5.6 CY stainless steel spreader from Summit Truck Group at Salina in the amount of $139,151 to be funded out of the new equipment reserve.
I'll second.
Okay, motion by Commissioner Jacobs, second by Commissioner Jones. I just want to comment. I had some actually co-workers today were talking about this, and they'd heard people talking about, why would we not take, the local bid? And I remember in 2013 we had a difference in about $400, and I kind of threw a fit to me, why would you not go local? But when you see a $20,000 difference, if not more, I don't know how you could go with a higher price. And I think all of us up here would always rather it be a local bid, but when you have that much of a difference, we would not be doing our job.
I totally agree with you, Mr. Chairman. I want to buy local every single opportunity we can, and personally, we do that in our household. But this is a significant difference.
And John, the International 7400 meets spec as put out?
Yes, it does. We're actually very pleased with that particular truck. We have a couple of those in the fleet already, and they're a good, solid truck.
Did the Peterbilt 348 exceed the specs in any way?
No, not necessarily. It's an equivalent truck.
Okay. We know the old truck is old because it's red, and we haven't purchased a red truck over 15, 20 years. Yes. We stopped buying red a long time ago. So that is old. Red.
Any comments? Okay. All in favor of the motion, say aye.
Aye.
This is 5-0. Thank you, John. Next item on the agenda, airport paint sprayer, award a bid.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and Commissioners. Ovid Seifers, Airport Manager. We are asking for approval to acquire a paint sprayer bid, a paint sprayer that we spec and has been bid on is that sprayer right there. And it's considerably different than the existing sprayer within the Public Works Division. This sprayer, number one, has 30 gallon capacity of paint versus 5, and 100 pounds of beads versus approximately 20. The biggest difference is the bead system is a pressurized system, which will get us on the good side of the FAA, because we have had a substantial problem with bead reflectivity and adhesion, and at night it does not reflect very well, and that is a finding in the past inspection since 2011 of that problem existing. So this will put an end to that era. The unacceptable condition on the left, the center line is painted with a truck which has a pressurized bead system and a much more pressurized paint applicator. The two lines, one on each side, is painted with the existing paint sprayer. The difference is what? The reflectivity and the bead adhesion is not near uniform or consistent. Therefore, it is a letter of finding by the FAA during their inspection. In the center, you see the same problem. Reflectivity is very poor. Even though it doesn't look so bad, that's really considered a very poor marking. And the two lines in the middle going left to right, you see streaks in the pattern. That's because of poor application from the paint dispenser and very poor bead adhesion. You have areas that just missed altogether on the edges and in the center. Not acceptable at all. Far right is a position hold sign. As you can see, that is in very poor condition. That was taken last November. The white numerals have very poor reflectivity, spotted, scattered, not uniform, not consistent. The red background should be reflective to a point, but not near as much as the white. But it has a very four painting pattern, and you can see bleed through from previous colors under the red. That's also unacceptable. Here's acceptable. All those markings there, with the exception of the red, were painted with a truck, again, pressurized bead applicator, pressurized paint applicator. Big difference, much more crisp lines, very uniform, good reflectivity. That was painted 18 months ago. Two bids were received. We advertised for bids and received these two bids. Bids were opened on April 11. Two bids for the same unit. Low bid was $19,884.65 from PMSI in Chandler, Arizona, a division of Craftco, who is big into paint sprayers and crack sealing and pavement maintenance equipment. And the other bid was from Missouri Turf and Paint in Kansas City, Missouri for $26,428, very same machine. Funding will come exclusively 100% from the airport contingency fund. Though this unit is being funded from the airport contingency fund, it will be used by Public Works Service Division and the airport. This is not an exclusive airport item. We will share and all be friends. Options: accept the bid from PMSI. Direct staff to another option, reject all bids. Recommendation: we recommend as a staff to award the low bid to PMSI for $19,884.65. They're in Chandler, Arizona. They do have a Kansas area field rep that takes care of warranty items and setup and things of that nature. So we're not getting something from Phoenix area, and they have to come here.
Mr. Chairman, I move we approve the low bid for the Graco Line Laser B250 SPS from Payment Supply Incorporated, the amount of not to exceed $19,884.65, funded out of the airport contingency fund.
Second.
Okay, motion by Commissioner Swaller, second by Commissioner Jones.
Comments? What is the warranty on it?
3 years.
Very good.
So on something like that, is there like efficiency that will be used on the street maintenance? I mean, be able to use something like that?
It paints a wider pattern, okay. And with a wider pattern, you can get a more uniform paint coverage, and you get more uniform bead coverage. Okay. Right now, we are restricted by width, and the narrower it is, the more seams you have in large markings on the airport.
Sure.
So it gives a kind of looks like wall siding appearance.
It's going to work on concrete and asphalt.
That works.
That works.
Much more efficient.
Good.
Thank you.
You bet. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. All in favor of the motion, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion passes 4-0. Report of the Assistant City Manager.
I have nothing.
We're going to have a lot of activity in town this weekend, and I just want to take the opportunity to congratulate all of the graduates at Fort Hays State University. I'm going to get to be part of some of it, and it brings a lot of wonderful people into our community for the whole weekend. So congratulations to all. Congratulations, Commissioner Schwaller, for finishing another year as a professor.
Mr. Wood, when you have a chance, would you please provide us with an update with Mr. Rip on the status of the CID at the mall property, specifically how much money has been collected to date and how it's been spent by the mall? Thank you.
I also like to congratulate all the local graduates and the teachers that survived another year. I know I've got a wife, been counting down the days for a few weeks now, so, and kids. So, and also happy Mother's Day to all, and you know, hopefully everybody gets out to enjoy their mom on Mother's Day, and we are adjourned.